Very slowly and gently, breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Gently bow your head down and seek the blessings of Sage Patanjali. Inhaling, come back and open your eyes. We first start with very slowly. You just rotate your head. You are doing this 5 times and very slowly, okay? If you have any pain anywhere in your neck, or you feel little giddy, then you are not doing anything of this. But otherwise, very simple. Just put your head, move your head like a ragda. You know, the stone which is used to grind the batter for idli. 5 times. Now, once you finish 5 times, then the opposite side. Now, roll your shoulders. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, opposite. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Very good. Now we are doing Shadasana. Shadasana is moving your head in 6 directions. So first is your extreme right. So look at your right side, and you are not touching the chin to the shoulder, but you will make an attempt to go closer to the shoulder, okay? Don't push too much that you will get a pain or maybe an extreme stretch. Don't do that. But see that you are taking your chin closer to the chest, closer to the shoulder. And when ending statement, breathe in, breathe out. Stay there. Now when you twist, you will feel a stretch that comes from behind the ears, going back till the neck. But feel that. Breathe in, breathe out. Now slowly move your head to the other side, to the left. Again, make an attempt of taking the chin closer to the shoulder. Breathe in, breathe out. You can again feel the stretch coming right from the back of your ear, and it is going straight down the neck, and it's even coming towards your throat. Breathe in and breathe out, come back. Now you will slowly drop your head behind, but be careful. You are not will drop your head behind and try to look at the ceiling. Breathe in. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe in. And breathing out, come back. Now, fourth direction, you will touch the chin to the chest. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. You will try to touch the chin to the chest. Breathe in and breathe out. And inhaling, come back. Now drop your head to your right side. That is the fifth direction. Breathe in, breathe out. And slowly go to the left side. Feel the stretch from your back till the neck. Very good. And come back. Now, a question that you have not asked me, but I still want to answer it. The question is, why we are not doing these movements faster? Like, Yasmin, you're listening? Yasmin? Stretch it nicely. Now take your hands up. Breathe in and breathe out. And slowly bring your hands down. One more time. Stretch your hands. And see, whatever I have told you now about ginger, you can practice this. And you can give me the feedback next time when we meet. But if you tell this solution to someone else, suppose you tell this to your son or to your daughter-in-law or maybe daughter or small child, and if they don't get the effect, then that is breathe in and breathe out. And slowly bring your hands down. Naina, you're not doing. Naina, aap nahi kar rahe ho. Okay. Now, bring your hand and come back. The other side, one more time. Breathe in nicely. and come back the other side. And come back. Now, take your legs together. Wherever you are sitting, you can stretch your legs out, and then we'll do point and flex. Point and flex. So do it 15 times. Count on your own and do it. Take your stretch your legs out nicely and point and flex. So when you're doing, give all your attention to your knee, wherever you have to tighten your knee. Okay. Tighten the kneecap and then release. Tight and release. Okay. Sure. Very slowly stretch your legs out. Point and flex. Point and flex. Very slowly, point and flex. And come back. Now try to touch your hand to your toes. See if you can touch your toes. If you can't, that is fine. If you can, go ahead. Now hold the toe and make hooks of your index fingers and touch your toe. Put it around your toe. Make hooks of your fingers and tuck it around your toes. Yes, very good. Razia, very good. Good. If you can't touch, that is okay. So wherever you can touch, maybe your knee or maybe till your shin bone, go do it. And come back. Okay. Now what you're doing is, now listen what I'm saying. Now what you're doing is, you will bring your knees together, ankles together, and feet together. Together. And you will hold it with both the hands. Okay. And what you will do is, if these are your legs, suppose, let me show you. Now, this is your chair. This is your chair. And these are your two legs, suppose. So bring the knees together and do it like this. One, two, three, four, five. Do it 10 times. Together, both the knees together, up and then down. Okay, let me see what you're doing. Yes. Count on your own with awareness. Hold the knees together. Hold the knees with your hands and then one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. main sound, like so it should be louder, and the humming sound should come from here. It should be louder, it should be strong, and you should hear it, and you should get a shivering sensation in your ears, nose, lips, teeth, cheeks, everywhere. Okay, so here we start. Make your elbows parallel to the ground. Yes. Now place your index finger on your lashes, not on your eyes. Now 3 times Omkar. You should prolong the ma. You should prolong the ma alphabet longer. Okay. Now, to end the session, let me tell you that it is quite cold in the morning nowadays. So what you can do is apply oil to your face, to your forearms, to your thighs and feet, and then take a hot water shower. Okay.